You can't adjust the wind, but you can adjust the sail. And that is the thought for today. Welcome to 7 Good Minutes. I'm Clyde Lee Dennis. Thanks for joining me for what I believe will be 7 of the most enriching minutes of your day. In today's audio, we learn how to win at the game of life by playing the long game. Enjoy.
The first value of excellence is this. You have to play the long game. You have to play the long game. Now, I know it's like, yeah, I know that. But listen, if you don't have the momentum you want in your life right now, you haven't been playing the long game. If you've been too stressed or too burned out, or you've overcommitted yourself, you're not playing the long game. If your health sucks, not playing the long game. If you're wrecking relationships, not playing the long game. If you don't have a vibrant, amazing community of peers around you, supporting your dream, cheering you on, not playing the long game. Because playing the long game does not just take what shows up, it architects the future. Oh, write it down. Playing the long game doesn't take what just shows up, it's architecting the future. And I think a lot of people live mediocre versus excellent lives because they weren't playing the long game. They weren't thinking like, okay, 3 years out, how do I scale? 3 years out, how do I stand out? 3 years out, how do I have success unparalleled in this industry? Because you know, and I both know, many of you are here because you're in transition and something new is coming along and you're trying something new. You got a new hobby, a new way to make money, a new way to serve. And sometimes in that transition, you go into survival mode. Survival mode is not the same as the excellence mentality, is it? Right? Survival mode is, let me take what's here, let me do the bare minimum to survive versus think strategically and play the long game. Now, I said a few things that I think are really important. Like, let's take that big old thing called burnout. Most people, when they've become burned out, it didn't happen immediately. It happened bit by bit by bit. I talked with my coaches this morning about that. It's like when someone's in burnout, don't think it was one big project that tipped them over the edge. It was little decisions, bit by bit by bit by bit by bit, where they gave away their time. They gave away their freedom. They overcommitted. They didn't say yes. They didn't say no. They didn't sort of like lay out the turf. They didn't set their boundaries. And over a period of time, they burned out. The problem, which I think you all know, is that if you're a high performer, you can survive on burnout for a long time. A lot of burnouts, you know, they're operating at a high level of efficiency. I mean, they're burned out, but they can go 6-7 months at that. And they don't take the time to step back and recharge throughout the day. Not once in a while on a vacation, throughout the day. They're not using transitions to recharge. They're not using those moments to like, whew, reset. Recharge, go at it again. And they don't do that because they believe they're invincible. They can't see all these decisions adding up to exhaustion, adding up to burnout, adding up to running out. Like always looking out a few months is part of excellence, isn't it? Otherwise, you can deliver excellence once and then you crash and burn. And many of you know this. Your success has been up and down. And really, if you look at the peaks and the valleys weren't successes. The peaks and the valleys were crashes. And that's how you know a person of excellence. Did they have this rhythm, this scale, this, even if there were some like lower points, were those rhythms of excellence? Or was it boom, launch that thing, crash. Boom, do that thing, great, crash. And it was just up, down, and it was just crash, 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 crash. A lot of people, I can look over the last 10 years, I'm like, your last 10 years wasn't defined by momentum or excellence. Your last 10 years was defined by like survival. It was defined by like luck. It was defined by crashes and burns and oh my God, you must be so tired. And you're like, yes, Brendon, I am. And that's why this is an important conversation today. If you know you're a person of excellence, and if it's true, I would not see a rhythm of crashing and burning. I would not see a rhythm of burns and busts, burning out, failures, and exhaustion. And it's really hard because I know, trust me, I there's so many nights I'm like, oh my God, if I just stay awake for 4 more hours, I can get these projects done. And you know what? And then I'm a complete idiot 72 hours later. I know it will catch up with me. Those who play the long game don't compromise in the short game because they know it catches up later. And that catch up is a devil. It is a bear. It is a beast. It knocks you down. And what happens is I'll compromise 3 hours here. But then because that compromise 3 hours here, you're knocked off your feet 3 days over here. So if you'd taken the 3 hours to recharge, you wouldn't be worthless for 3 days in the middle of the week, right? I want you to have steady rhythm. That's what we call high performance, that ability to have long-term success while maintaining your well-being and your health, my friends. You so deserve that.
Please keep in mind, this is about half of the entire presentation. If you're up for a treat, you should definitely listen to the whole thing. You can do so by clicking the link labeled View the Full Video on YouTube in the show notes. So that does it for this episode of 7 Good Minutes. Until next time, let's be civil to one another out there. Thanks for listening.